Hey, what's going on, guys? Mush back at it with another video. I want to cover the spring cleaning event that Steam is running right now. However, there is some really funny stuff also going on over on Twitch. It seems like Valve's Artifact is getting absolutely trolled. I don't know how many of you guys actually picked up on this, but if you go on over to Twitch and then you go to the Artifact page, yeah, people are doing some strange stuff. So I wanted to talk a little bit about that because I didn't see a lot of people highlighting it, but also Heavy Rain's PC demo was supposed to be released yesterday. Unfortunately, it seems like in typical Epic fashion, things went awry. It wasn't really their fault. However, it looks like Quantic Dream wanted to implement Denuvo into the game, anti-tamper tech, and that kind of broke the game and you couldn't even start it up. So the demo was pulled, but now it's back up. And for all of you guys saying that you couldn't play the demo, now it is working, so try it out now. We'll talk that at the end of this video. But first up, as a part of the spring cleaning event that Valve is running right now on Steam, you can play 7 games free this weekend. I believe 7. Yeah, 7 games free this weekend. And there are some great titles you can check out, including Dead by Daylight, Endless Space 2, which is pretty awesome. That's a 4X strategy game. You've got Grim Dawn, which is awesome. Don't Starve Together, Black Desert Online Remastered. That's pretty good. Assetto Corsa, and Left 4 Dead 2. In terms of quality, Left 4 Dead 2 is probably the best game here. I just thought that game was awesome, and if you play with a couple of friends, it's one of the best co-op shooters that you're gonna come across. And now with all of these games, you can also enjoy steep discounts on them. For example, Left 4 Dead 2 is down to $2.50. Black Desert Online is down to $5. I believe Endless Space 2 is seeing like a 66% off discount. Yes, it is down to $13 and change. And you can get deals on everything else as well, but you can obviously try out the games before you buy them and your progress will carry over. This is not a sale, however. I think some people are getting it misconstrued. This is just a spring cleaning event. They did it last year. It kicked off yesterday at 10 a.m. Pacific time, and it will be wrapping up May 28th at 10 a.m. Also, along with all of this running, they do have daily tasks available that you can get badges and increase your Steam level. It really doesn't contribute to anything really noteworthy, but I always like Steam doing quirky events like this. I believe they've been doing this one for the last couple of years. To go over some of them, they have Speed Clean. Several games are available to play for free during the whole event. They've picked a couple for you to try, and then their Spin Cycle. Can't decide what to play? Let us help you out. We'll pick some random games in your library that you can play to upgrade your badge, clear the backlog, own a game that you haven't played, give it a try, and increase your badges level. And then there's projects as well. There's the Nostalgia Project. Play a game you've played more than 2 hours of but haven't played in a while. Can't Wait. Play a game you purchased within the last 6 months. Trusted Friend. Play a game recommended by a friend. Blast from the Past. Play the first game you added to your Steam account. If you completed this task last year, play the second game on your Steam account. So that's a pretty cool incentive that they're running. I don't even remember the first game I added to my Steam account. I want to say it was Red Orchestra 2. That was the first game I got really into, but I'm sure I downloaded some weird and quirky free-to-play title before I played Red Orchestra 2. But there you have that, and there's also Tag Contributor. Play a game that uses a tag you've applied to another Steam game. So cool little event they're running. Very smart on their part. They're trying to get you to clear out your backlog so then they can kick off the summer sale, and then they can have people with an empty backlog to buy more games. I think that is some good strategy by Valve, a good way to get people to buy some more games. And I'm all for Steam doing more stuff like this. At the very least, you've got 7 quality free-to-play weekends, all of those games having a sale. Again, from my recommendation, Left 4 Dead 2, you guys have probably already played that, but that's quite good to go ahead and play. Grim Dawn is pretty awesome. 70% off for $7.49 is great, and all the other stuff is pretty good as just free weekends. Okay, moving on from that, that's some great stuff going on with Valve right now. Cool stuff happening on Steam. However, some of you guys might not be aware of what's going on the Twitch page for Valve's title Artifact. Well, it seems like people are totally memeing Artifact, as they just are going on the Artifact page and doing things I'm pretty sure you're not allowed to do on Twitch. So the top stream, if you look under Artifact right now, is literally somebody streaming Scary Movie 5. The second most viewed stream is literally somebody streaming The Dark Knight Rises. Wall Street is being streamed. I believe somebody streaming One Punch Man. Somebody was streaming Food Wars earlier. I don't know what's going on. I don't know why people have decided to just start memeing on Artifact, but I'll leave a link to it in the description box below. Obviously, you should not be doing this, but it seems like Twitch is trying to take down these channels. I don't know why it's taking them so long, because I'm pretty sure the stream with Scary Movie 5 is about to wrap up the entire stream, so that's a little crazy that this is even happening. But nonetheless, by the time you guys are watching this video, maybe it got remedied, maybe everything is fixed, but that's something funny I wanted to note. One of my friends actually pointed it out to me, and I imagine at some point that this is gonna spread like wildfire. And it's gonna get more attention, and maybe I'm doing it a disservice because people want this to go a little bit under the radar and just keep doing what they're doing, but nonetheless, there you have it. And lastly, I noticed in yesterday's video that a lot of you guys commented noting that the Heavy Rain PC demo was not working for you. However, that has been fixed. Quantic Dream noted that our team has found issues and is working hard to fix it. We will give you an update tomorrow morning at 10 a.m. CEST. Thank you again for your patience and understanding. It looks like it was because of Denuvo. I'm not quite sure, but it does have Denuvo anti-tamper tech. However, Quantic Dream updated saying, good news, the issue is fixed, the demo is now available, thank you for being patient and have a good moment. So you can play through the demo. As I mentioned yesterday, it's a 45-minute demo, and it does encompass the first two chapters of the game. A lot of you guys were dropping spoilers in the comments section. Come on, guys, Heavy Rain is a story-driven game, can you at least let people enjoy the story of the game? Somebody spoiled literally the biggest plot twist in the game, so that was a little bit unfortunate, but I deleted that comment quite quickly. But nonetheless, Heavy Rain is a quality game. Yes, it's an EGS exclusive, but you can get it for $10 as a part of the Epic Mega Sale, and I would say for that price, it is worth it. It is, in my opinion, Quantic Dream's best title. I think it's better than Detroit Become Human. I think it's way better than Beyond Two Souls, and I do, in fact, think it's better than Fahrenheit Indigo Prophecy. Fahrenheit was an alright game, but at this point in 2019, it just hasn't aged all too well. So, Heavy Rain's PC demo back up, and I would recommend you to at least check that out. Shouldn't be too difficult to run either. And that's going to conclude this video, guys. Again, Steam is running their spring cleaning event. They've got some cool badges and trophies that you can get, but really the best part about it is the free-to-play weekend. You got Dead by Daylight, Endless Space 2, Grim Dawn, which I highly recommend, Don't Starve Together, which is awesome as well, Black Desert Online Remastered, which definitely has its issue, but a quality play, Assetto Corsa, and Left 4 Dead 2, and Left 4 Dead 2 is obviously tremendous. I imagine a lot of you guys own a lot of those titles, but for the majority of you, there's probably at least a couple of games that you can try out for the first time for free this weekend. Again, that'll be wrapping up May 28th. I'll leave a link to the Artifacts Twitch page in the description box below. Obviously, I don't condone any of this. I just thought it would be a funny thing to note that people are memeing so hard about this. I didn't even really talk about Artifact, the game itself, but obviously, it was trying to be a quality card game like Hearthstone. It was gaining a little bit of traction initially, but then it just completely fell off the face of the earth, so that's a little bit of a bummer. And then Heavy Rain's PC demo has been pulled from the Epic Game Store, and it does use Denuvo anti-tamper tech, but now it has come back, and you guys should be able to play it no problem. And that's going to conclude this video, guys. If you have a request for a future video, you can leave that in the comments section down below, and I will catch you guys in the next one. Peace out. Hey, what's going on, guys? Mush here again. Hope you enjoyed the video. As you guys might know, YouTube's notification system is sometimes a little bit wonky, even if you're subscribed to the channel. Maybe you're not abundantly aware that I uploaded a video. To remedy that situation, make sure you hit the bell notification button. This way, whenever I upload a new video, and I try to upload as consistently as possible, you will be notified directly of the upload, and you can watch it as soon as it goes live. I would really appreciate if you guys hit that button, so you can stay up to date with all of the content I'm posting. But as always, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace out.